We are going into a 1v1 on House. It's Ben versus Robert.
I read to myself so I can comment on everything that's going on. Ben is sitting in the right corner of kid's bedroom and Robert has no idea that he's there, looking through the window, can hear a bit of shooting, but doesn't know where he's from. Drops down onto the treehouse and now he's going to start to rappel up. Nope, goes around to the door, breaks in from the bottom. Now Ben has some idea as to if he is downstairs or not. We're going to see what Ben is doing now. Ben is still chilling in kid's bedroom waiting for him to pop on. He's got all of the mats, as you can see. This is very hard to control. All of the mats set up in kid's bedroom, so even if he tries to come in, he will be trapped shortly. Now Rob walks into kid's bedroom. I don't believe he realizes that the mats are there, so he's probably just gonna rush in and get frost matted anyway. He's shooting through the wall, shoots Ben a little bit, and Ben is now down to a little bit of health. Very low here. Very critical condition and for Ben, and Rob still there with full HP. I don't know why commentating is really hard. I'm just describing everything that's going on. Anyway, Ben hasn't reinforced anything, so this gives a lot of potential for Rob to just wall bang and wall bang and wall bang, giving a lot of pressure onto Ben. Now, Rob pushing in again. Don't know if he realizes that all the frost mats are there, but we're going to see and find out. Doing a little bit of wall banging. You know he's got 200 bullets, so he can be doing this all day. One bar of health, and there's 15 seconds on the clock. Rob pushing to Ben and gets the kill. Rob gets the kill. Wall bang after wall bang, and finally, he ends up shooting Ben on the bed. At nominal scenes right here. Ben had nearly had the upper hand of that one. Got a few shots onto him, and there is the end of round one. And as we can see from the operator selections, Ben has decided to go blitz. Now he's breaking in through top floor. Just gonna rush in there with blitz as you do, flashing Rob. And now Rob should be blind. Rob is not able to see anything, and Rob gets the knife in from behind onto blitz. Absolutely phenomenal scenes. Absolutely counters blitz. I heard a little bit of struggling there before, a bit of rage, but now he's able to counter blitz. Absolutely phenomenal. It's incredible to see it when somebody tries to troll the other teammate and it turns out it just backfires. It all up in their face. Absolutely amazing to see the, you know, lessons being learned on how to deal with annoying operators like that. Mm-hmm. It's incredible. The score is 2-0 up for Robert. Oh boy. I would honestly make a terrible commentator. I do not care. We're going basement, garage. Ben is going mirror, one of his star operators. Knows how to use her properly, kind of. Don't tell Ben that I said that. Anyway, Ben getting his setup done. Only adds two reinforcements, so he has to choose wisely and where to put them. Places both mirrors on both sides, you know, to get an advantage as to where blitz, you know, the operator that these two find very annoying, is coming from. We see where blitz is. Blitz is on the left side. Ben is not able to see him right now. He's moving away from the mirror. He's sitting in the corner next to the Hoover Henry Hoover. And now we are going to see if Ben is able to counter the blitz as well as Robert was able to counter it. It's a true lesson as to who is good at the game and who plays the game. So we have them two nearly coming to meet in each other. They are able to hear each other. Blitz is not able to see. Kills Blitz. That's why you should always be droning, kids. Droning is very important. It's a very, very, very rookie mistake. And it would have been, I've got to be honest, it would have been a game. The round would have gone to Blitz if he did drone. But obviously, no. Mira took him down. I wouldn't say it was a counter. I would say it's just a mistake made by the opposing team, which allowed him to take the kill and take the round. Potentially take the game? Who knows? We'll find out near the end. Fuse getting objective to try and get the mirror, but mirror is on the opposite side of the room. The fuses are going in, but they're missing every single one. Fuse is now damaging himself with the fuse charges, so this gives a little bit of an advantage to the mirror. If mirror could potentially run out and get the fuse, but now... Oh! going into objective and using the fuse charge to bring out the mirror to give him more time to get the secure area. Now, is mirror able to walk back in and defeat the fuse? He's got the mirror there, shooting at fuse a little bit, and he has lost the round because he was not able to get in time inside the room. Why don't we take a little break, like a very small one, to promote. Today's video is sponsored by my Twitch. Subscribe, follow me on Twitch, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Both the hype creator. Thank you very much. Anyway, back from the break. Now Robert going on to the rappel, gonna try and breach into the room. I say try, he did actually indeed breach into the room, and now he's got the candelas trying to blind Legion, forcing him out of the area and going into the main lobby. Throwing the yings everywhere, but doesn't realize that he is still very able to see, getting a few wallbangs into there, and now he's about to secure the objective. The objective is being secured. Legion is just walking a bit to the right. He's covered up by the ACOG, but he was still able to flick onto him. Insane plays by Robert. Would nearly died, but thankfully with the insane reaction timing, he was able to shoot Ben right in the head. It was, oh, that was just beautiful. I have nothing else to say about that. What do you think about that?
Well,
I don't know who I'm talking to. As you can see, Ben has gone ying because he got yinged. So now Robert is prepared for that and has gone warden. Warden, if you didn't know, has glasses that prevent him from getting flashbanged, and he's also able to see through smoke. Ben does not have smoke, so all Robert has to worry about is the flash grenades. This is hard. This is actually hard. This is a skill. This is a skill that takes years of training. I have none. Ben is still droning even though he has spawned in. The game has started and he has just wasted 8 seconds of his life droning. Imagine that. Anyway, Warden is in master bedroom and now Ying is taking out all the cameras just to be, you know, be precaution. Robert was about to go for a small peek, but I think he realized that would be very risky. Let's check it out. Let's see. Yes, he does indeed have ACOG and angled grip. So that's going to be some fast reaction timing. He can just flick onto him any day. Now, Rob is in construction, waiting for Ying to, you know, get in a position where he can shoot out the windows. He doesn't realize that. Never mind. He was about to go on the roof, but now he's not on the roof anymore. He's looking back at the construction window, but Rob has now moved away from that area. He's trying to get a cheeky wall bang like he did. I'll show you the one that he did me. I'm not going to. Anyway, back to the game. Ben is on top of the roof, waiting for a chance to put his yings into action. I don't think he realizes that he is playing warden, so even if he does try and... Oh! And he gets the wall bang! Robert instantly knew where he was somehow. Ben was trying to put a candela in, but Rob was just able to get the kill. It's all a bit mad. That was a bit weird. Still, there's a bit of controversy into whether Rob should have got that kill or not, because apparently Ben was out of the way, but no.
They've chosen the operators.
They've chosen the place where they want to spawn. And now, it all comes down to this. Will we get a nice finish in the end? Cheeky wallbang maybe. Or a nice tasty small peek. That is a little bit controversial. However you say the word. The game has started. I'm going to mute my mic now. Ben is indeed trying to go for the spawn peek. Very naughty of him indeed. He's checking the cameras to see where Nock is hiding. Nock is still currently droning, so Ben is wasting his time, effort and money trying to go for the spawn peek when he doesn't realize that Nock is indeed still droning. He hasn't moved from the position that he's in, so Nock may try and go into that position. Doesn't realize that Nock is on the other side of the map, not where he wants it to be, so he's still waiting, and now he realizes that Nock is in a different position. I sound like the guy from Big Bang. Yeah. Big time rush. And now the drones are going in. He's throwing an impact because he thinks Nock is on the stairs, but Nock is actually currently still outside droning in at every angle, making sure that he gets the win. Now he's breaking it from downstairs, hasn't hit it quite right, so he's now breaking up in the whole barricade, giving a sound warning as to where his position currently is. Ben is currently watching the stairs at a very tight angle, not a pixel angle, but it is a tight angle, leaning the wrong way, exposing a part of his body. So this gives a chance for Robert to just walk in, shoot a part of his body, and he is dead. But if Ben has good accuracy and is able to get a nice, clean, tasty headshot, then it should be game over. Robert now has no drones left, and Ben is now making an impact grenade onto the wall. They're both on the stairs. They're both watching the stairs. He doesn't realize that Ben is right on his left. There's a gunfight happening. There's both getting shot at. Ben is lower than the other one. He does a nice flick to get the pistol kill. What's going to happen here? Oh, it's all happening so fast. It's Rob Levitt's getting killed. Both use the pistols, and Rob gets the win. He gets the win on to Ben. Insane gunfight. Intense. We get the final kill cam. It's all a little bit mad. Rob won the game. It's over. Right. It's clear to see who is the winner. I would say winner, but there needs to play one more game to see who is the true winner. That was a very intense game. Thank you for watching. And I will probably see you either in another video or later.